Hey, John Sonmez from simpleprogrammer.com. I've got a bit of a long question. This is kind of an interesting one, and there might be some profanity. I try to keep the content pretty clean, but I might get a little worked up about this topic here, because this is, in fact, it's funny because the subject line was a quick question, but this isn't really a quick question. But anyway, so I'm just gonna tell you what I think, like I usually do here. But this question comes from Ronnie, and it says, John, I just discovered your blog and you, and I've been reading your thoughts on C++ and why you think it's not strictly necessary to learn as a language. Beyond what it imparts to you about memory structuring and addressing and so on, with that in mind, here are a few questions for you. One, shouldn't it bother a programmer when they're completely dependent on proprietary systems like C#, owned by a megalomaniac Pacific Northwestern patent attorney and his born on third base son who didn't even have to complete his bachelor's degree at Harvard because he happened to go to Lakeside Prep in Seattle, where one of two teletype terminals in the world at the time happened to be located? Shouldn't it bother a new programmer to be dancing to the tune of such people by playing into their proprietary hands-on, enmeshing themselves with such a global syndicate? So that's question one. Kind of negative. Question two, to what extent should it bother a programmer or aspiring one that he or she doesn't know how a compiler works, much less the one which makes his program actually work? This is obviously not a C or C++ question particularly, but it's a concern I've always had about the general sense of entitled brattiness and narcissism so many programmers have, or what they can make a computer do when their understanding of how it's all possible is shallow at best. Little also negative. Number three, on a completely different note, you seem perhaps Latino in an industry that I seem to have noticed has blacks and Latinos and also most Mediterraneans tactically designated as the non-technological races, as opposed to people of Northern Europe or Asian ethnicity. Have you experienced anything along those lines? If so, how have you dealt with that? If not, do you think it doesn't exist, or do you think you've enjoyed special circumstances that have somehow exempted you from such treatment, and what they are, if I may ask? Okay. Lots of bombs here. This is gonna be fun when I finally address this. Finally, I've been reading an awful lot about an incredible amount of age discrimination in the programming field, where even people in their 30s are being openly mocked in the workplace as elderly and so on. How would you suggest people deal with that in this industry? And also, putting all sympathy for people's feelings aside, is there an age where people should no longer consider trying to retrain from some other field to learn programming? 30, 40, 50? Question mark. Okay, so we've kind of hit on all that. There's no religion in here, so that's interesting. To continue on, when I was a kid, the computer industry certainly seemed like a much less shallow and, dare I say, sharkish field than it is now. Computer people used to foster a love for the machine, the philosophy, and the process itself than they do now. Nowadays, the computer field looks very much like the David Marnett play Glengarry Glen Ross, where the second place winner gets a set of steak knives and third place winner gets fired. So what do you think of what I've just said here? Sincerely, Ronnie. So where to begin here? I'm not going to answer these questions, by the way, just because these questions are not relevant. I love this email, by the way, Ronnie. I'm not trying to make fun of you, but this was not a quick question, by the way. So if you subject lining a quick question, that was a little bit. I don't know if you intended it to be a quick question or you thought it was going to be, but anyway, nice email. Very negative though. Here's the thing. Here's my answer. My basic answer to all four of your questions that you've asked here is I literally don't give a shit. Like, I don't care that Microsoft made C# and that his son was privileged in life. I don't care. I don't care that people don't know how compilers work when they can do their jobs. I don't care that I'm not Latino, but if I was, I don't care if someone would discriminate against me. I literally don't give a shit about any of that stuff. Literally, I don't care. I don't care about age discrimination. I don't care if someone wants to discriminate against me because they think that I have a big nose. I don't give a shit about any of that stuff. I don't, because I don't have time for it. And you shouldn't either. Like, you know, when I read your email, honestly, Ronnie, the thing is, like, you are spending so much time just hating and being negative that it's like you need to just not give a shit, honestly. Like, I don't like to use profanity, but I'm gonna, like, I just wanna tell it to you straight. And, like, don't give a shit about all this stuff. You know, you're spending so much time, like, just being bitter and just, like, you know, seething about how things are unfair in life and how you're being discriminated against and all that. And yes, I acknowledge all this stuff happens. Yeah, age discrimination happens. Yes, racism and discrimination happens in life. And yes, people don't know stuff that they should know, and they get promoted anyway, and they get moved up to the architect's position where someone more deserving doesn't. And you know, all that stuff happens. But if you concern yourself with all that stuff, you're just going to be bitter, and you're never going to accomplish anything, and you're going to hate your life. I mean, heck, you know, when you get dealt a bad hand, you got to play that hand. So you know, things are going to happen. You know, life is going to happen. But I literally do not care about any of that stuff. All that stuff that you listed in your email, I don't even give it a second thought, not even a bit. Yeah, I've been discriminated against. Yeah, all kinds of things have happened. I've had hard knocks in life. Yes, I've been on the other end of a baseball bat. Yeah, all that stuff has happened to me, and it happens to a lot of people. And some people, you know, have a golden spoon in their mouth, and that's fine. But it, you know, what you should concern yourself with, and everyone should, is themselves. Is you. What can you do? What can you do about your situation? How can you improve your situation? Don't worry about everyone else. Don't worry about all this stuff. Life is not fair, right? You know, a lot of people just believe that life should be fair, and it's not fair. So don't like believe that it is. Don't try and make things fair. You can't control other people. You can't control this stuff. You're just, you know, again, you know, I'm glad you sent me this email, but I fear for you because of your negativity. Because I feel like, you know, if you have this belief, like, you know, all these questions that you ask, none of them, literally, I do not give a shit about any of them. They do not matter to me, and they shouldn't matter to you. So, you know, do what you can do, live your life. Don't worry about this kind of stuff. Don't be bitter. Life is too short to be bitter. You can just spend your whole life just seething and being angry about injustices in the world and in your own life, and you just have wasted it. So that's my advice. I didn't really answer your question. I know it, but you didn't really ask a quick question, did you? So anyway, hopefully you found this useful. Hopefully someone did. And yeah, so that's it. That's what I got to say about that. If you like this video, if you'd like to hear me say don't give a shit anymore, then subscribe to this channel. And if you don't subscribe to this channel, I don't give a shit. So take care.